We've been asked by our clients to create a nice poster design for a local sports team, the Murray High School Tigers. It's actually my alma mater, and I'm going to design a nice little poster design using a three-dimensional logo. But first, I have to get their logo into this document. So in order to do that, I need to go over to Illustrator. Inside of Illustrator, I have the Tigers logo already loaded up here. I'm just going to grab that, copy it to the clipboard, bring it back over into Photoshop, and paste it in. Now, the Smart Object section here is what I'm going to select. I'm also going to make sure to uncheck Add to My Library. So if I hit OK, this just places it directly into the document for me. Now, I'm going to increase the size of this just a little bit. Now, in and of itself, this is a pretty cool logo, but the problem is that black background doesn't really contrast well with the dark background of what we're working with here. So we need a way to keep it just as it is, but to make it stand out a little bit more and to give it a little bit more of an aggressive type feel. This is a football team, after all. So we're going to use 3D in order to do that. But now that we have our logo in place here inside of Illustrator, we just want to make sure that we get it exactly where we want it, size it up, and once you have yours in there, you can go ahead and proceed to the next step where we're going to extrude this out into three-dimensional space and then start adding textures and lighting effects. Now that we have our logo placed into our document, first thing I'm going to do is rename it to Tiger Logo. It just makes it easier for me to find it inside of the Layers panel. Next up, what we're going to do is we're going to actually extrude it into 3D space. That's the easy part of this. We're going to go up to the 3D menu and choose New 3D Extrusion from Selected Layer. Once we do that, it's going to jump into the 3D workspace. It's going to extrude our logo for us and allow us to start manipulating it. I'll zoom in just on the logo so you can see it. And what we're going to do is just start moving it a bit. So here on the Z axis, I can move it sort of towards the front or towards the back. I'm going to move it more towards the front. And then let's give this a little bit of a rotation. Something kind of like this. There we go. And I'll zoom out so we can kind of see what's going on here. Now, the extrude depth is something we need to play with here. The extrusion depth way too large, in my opinion. So let's just kind of do this. We want it to almost look like a floating, like a badge is sitting there in a way. And so once we have that done, I'm going to back that down to about 0.5. Five, I think. 0.555. There we go. And so once we have that all set up, we're pretty much ready to go. Now, in this case, I also want to work a little bit on the lighting effect here. So in order to do that, I'm going to grab the infinite light, and I can kind of play around with where the light goes here. So the light kind of shining down on it like that, maybe over a little bit. I want the shadow to be cast out behind it a little bit, so that way there's some depth in here, almost like the football player's in the front, the badge is right behind him, and then the text that we set in the background will be behind that. Now, I'm also going to kind of give this a little bit of a tilt here, just because I've got a little bit of that extra gray showing up out there, and I don't really want that. Now, I've flipped it over completely. Let's fix that. Here we go. I want to kind of tilt it back. There we go. Just kind of sitting there almost like a pin that you would drop in like Google Maps or something like that. This just kind of stabbing into the ground kind of effect. And then let's rotate it just a little bit more on that Y-axis. Turn it a little bit more towards the player. There we go. We can see a little bit more of that hard edge over there. It looks good. And you just play around with this. Get it exactly like you want it. But once that's in there and you got it exactly like you want it, zoom out a bit. Click away from it. That way you can kind of see what's going on. If you want to switch back to your Layers panel, collapse that up and select the background, you can kind of see what this looks like. And you may want to move it around, adjust it, that kind of thing. In this case, I'm going to select it here and just kind of move it around until I get it exactly where I want it to be. So I want it back a little bit, to the left a little bit. There we go. Select the background. That looks pretty good. So it's just kind of sitting there. Might want to adjust the tilt just a little bit more. Tilt it a little bit more forward, maybe. There we go. Okay. There. That looks pretty good. Okay. Now, once we have this all positioned in here and you got it just exactly like you like it, you can then start to think about how you want this to look in terms of texture and lighting and stuff like that.